In today's video, I will be showing you how to get the Jack Frosty Assault Rifle Blueprint for the SCAR in Modern Warfare. Now, I've got some good news and I've got some bad news. Bad news is this is a PlayStation exclusive, at least until October 2020. Good news? Well, it's just a blue and black cosmetic variant. And if you wanted to, you could recreate the exact same setup. It just won't look like it. First thing is, what exactly is the Jack Frosty? So I'll show you what it comes with stock and then the little mods that I like to run with, what you see in the gameplay in the background there. All right, so first up, let's load up the SCAR, go to the armory, and here is the Jack Frosty. Let's go ahead and click on that. Here it is in its default form. You see that you have 4 out of the 5 slots equipped. So here's the barrel it comes with, the Forge Tac CQC Pro. And yeah, it's kind of bugged how it kind of shows it there. But if you change that, that completely changes its look. Okay, so let's just, you know, put on this one right here and it just completely ruins it. All right, so that's a big thing. But good news is that the ADS speed is really good and the movement speed is increased. And the whole overall setup is to make it a very fast run and gun setup. The optic that it comes with, personally, it's not for me. It comes with the reflex sight, but you can change it to whatever you want and it'll keep the look, keeps the overall look. So that way, if you want to run the mini reflex, that's okay. It's not going to change it. But personally, I like to run no sight, no sight, just to increase the ADS speed. And we have 2 extra points there. And I like to run the laser sight. Why not get some hipfire accuracy? So the stock. Now the stock, you can change it a little bit and it won't really mess up the look unless you go down to the Pro and it just looks, it doesn't look very good. So, you know, you could have a little bit of leeway with that, but you know, the collapsible stock, that one's really good. It has good movement speed and good ADS speed. And then finally, it comes with sleight of hand, which is really good for the SCAR. And you notice we have 1 point to spend. Here's the thing, if you want to change the ammunition, get yourself a bigger clip. It really makes it look ugly. It just puts a big beige clip in there and it just totally kills it. So yeah, you want that nice black look, you just got to have it on default. And the only other option to really finish off this gun is to have a nice grip on it, aim down sight speed, sprint to fire speed. That's available on the first one. Hey, that's a great choice. Perfect. Great setup. And that is the setup that I'm using in the gameplay in the background. And finally, if you're curious, what does it look like in gold? Well, it kind of looks like the old SCAR, the normal SCAR, except it has a blue tip and the blue trigger. But if you're just going to run gold, just run gold under default. It kind of kills the whole purpose of getting the Jack Frosty. Now, even if you decide that you'll never use the Jack Frosty, it's worth doing the mission just for the XP alone. In all, you'll end up with 30,000 XP by the time the whole thing's finished. And even more if you remember to pop a double XP token right before you complete it. So the great thing about the SCAR is it's almost always a one-shot kill in hardcore, and that is what I played pretty much to get all the challenges done. With the first challenge being get 50 kills using assault rifle equipped with the sniper scope optic. You get 2000 XP for that, and they literally mean the sniper scope. I was looking at all the different scopes trying to figure out which one it is. Nope, it is called Sniper Scope, and it turns it into a sniper. The class setup I ended up running was a laser sight, had the Sniper Scope, obviously, close quarter stock, sleight of hand, and a 30 round mag. The zoom is pretty big, but of course, it's a Sniper Scope. And the reason why I ended up going with the laser sight is so I could hip fire. I was messing around, testing it, and you don't need to aim down sights for the kills to count. You can just run around hip firing if you don't feel like sniping, which I did not feel like doing. So if Hardcore Shoot House 24/7 is active, you may want to jump in there, hip fire, run around, and you'll get that done quick. Next up for 2500 XP, objective 2 is play 5 matches of the co-op survival mode. And as you guys know, survival is a PSN exclusive at least until October 2020. So assuming they keep all the challenges the same, it's looking like the Jack Frosty won't won't be available on other platforms until that same time, October 2020. So with that, we go to objective 3 for 3000 XP. Get 10 point blank kills using an assault rifle. Kind of a passive challenge, but you could bum rush people on Shoot House if you want. Then it's objective 4 for 4000 XP, call in 25 killstreaks. Super duper easy, why not just run all the lowest stuff, personal radar, UAV or counter, whatever you want, and then one of the missile streaks. Slap on hardline, hey, 2 kills, gets you that personal radar, you'll get it done like in what, 1 or 2 games. Then it's objective 5, get 5 headshots using the 357 Magnum for 5k XP. So for this, of course, you could just stay in hardcore mode, but don't forget that there is a realism mode, and in there is increased damage to the head. But I tend to like headquarters, I'm used to it, I know the spawns. Some people actually play the objective, and so that makes it really easy to find other players, know where they're going. And other than that, I just slapped on a red dot to help me aim better. Then we have a passive challenge, objective 6, get 5 double kills, 6000 XP. I mean, this thing is just full of XP. Like I said, even if you don't care about the weapon, why not do it just for the XP alone? By the time you get to the last two objectives, don't forget to pop a double XP token right before you complete it. And then there's a final objective, objective 7, get 75 kills while Operator Cid is selected. And you don't even have to be her in game, and what that means is, let's say that you end up being on the Coalition side, as long as you have Cid selected out in your preferences and the menu, that's fine, it's gonna count. You actually do not have to be her character in game. And that's it, very easy, lots of easy XP. Like I said, 30,000 XP, maybe more if you use a double XP token. So if this helped, please be sure to like the video. And on the left side there is a whole playlist of the Modern Warfare tips, and on the right, a brand new video.